On the Medical Watch, a potential HIV breakthrough.
As medical reporter Dina Baer explains, it could also play a role in battling COVID-19.
Scientists have identified a group of people who, even though infected, show no viral level of HIV. Now, they hope to harness the virus-fighting ability and transform it into a better therapy and perhaps even a cure. Massive numbers of people in the Democratic Republic of Congo are infected with HIV. A select group doesn't show it.
We found that there were actually a large number of patients who didn't have any virus to even sequence.
Abbott scientists have been tracking the virus that causes AIDS since 1985 in 45 different countries. In all, 76 million have been infected. 38 million are currently living with HIV. 26 million are in Africa. And that's where the super fighters with no detectable virus live now.
We found that there were about 4% of all the people with HIV and DRC who are able to naturally control HIV without taking any medication.
What's in their DNA that boosts their immunity? That's the next focus for research.
We have so many people that we can now follow and understand what makes them unique and see clear trends that we could more easily translate into new treatments and vaccines. This could be groundbreaking if these people are able to potentially teach us how to suppress HIV.
Along with the amazing finding, a disturbing one identified last year, a new variant of HIV. Like most viruses, it mutated, and that means the search for a cure is that much more pressing.
So there's a sense of urgency that we need to find new treatments, and we may potentially learn about some through this group of amazing people.
The quest is similar in the desperate search for answers in the current pandemic fighting SARS-CoV-2.
We've taken what we've learned about how we need to be able to detect a lot of different strains of HIV with just one diagnostic test, and that's taught us how to make a test for SARS-CoV-2 that can detect all the many new variants that we're now seeing. Viruses never stop, and neither do we. We need to remain vigilant and make sure that we know which strains are circulating and use those samples and sequences to make sure that our diagnostic tests continue to work.
Working together has been the key, battling a virus that first hit the stage in the 1980s to the one that upended our lives in 2020. Collaboration has yielded answers and hope.
The ability to respond as quickly as the scientific community has by creating diagnostic tests really quickly and generating vaccines and potentially, you know, some therapies as well with antibodies now being in use. So it's really nice to see how quickly the scientific community has responded. And so I'm very optimistic that everything we're doing is going to help us make significant decreases in the number of COVID cases.
The global study of viruses has ramped up, and it's back to the lab, studying what makes some seemingly immune to an HIV infection, while others are asymptomatic with COVID-19. It's the science that will make the real difference for survival.